So you're curious if you can reprogram your mind. Is that even possible? Well, I'm here today to tell you that you can. And the reason I know that is because I have done just that. What's going on, guys? Marcus here to Discover Ignite. And today we're talking about reprogramming your brain. Now, I don't know, there's a lot of skeptics out there that are probably like, there's no way you can reprogram your brain, but I'm telling you, it's true, it's possible. I've done it. This is something you can do. It takes time, it takes effort. Just like everything, it takes repetition, and it can be done. You can reprogram your brain to think completely different things. Now, we have to understand here that our subconscious actually controls 99% of what we do. Now, if you go back to anything you've actually learned, right? Everything, that particular task seems mundane and like just extremely hard to do, right? And it's not until we push ourselves through that task that it slowly becomes part of our subconscious. Once it gets to that subconscious part of our brain, it's automatic and it doesn't seem so mundane. It doesn't seem so hard that we can actually do it without even thinking. This, you know, can be anywhere from, you know, walking to driving. You notice that all these things, once they hit that subconscious, they just become a lot easier with little to no actually effort on our part to, you know, do these, execute whatever tasks that we're trying to do. So we know ultimately that our subconscious is the key. This is where we want to actually implant good habits, right? Now, we have to understand that a lot of our subconscious is developed, you know, in our younger years before we are actually seven. And that doesn't mean that we can't change anything. That just means that they establish beliefs, right? And these beliefs, the longer you have a particular belief, you know, the harder it may be to change, the more time and effort you're gonna have to actually put into changing that belief. But it is possible to change those beliefs. You just have to understand that you can't put limitations, right? You may have a belief that you can only make, you know, $20,000, and that's your belief. And if that's what you believe in, then you will never be able to make more than that. Now, you can actually change your thinking and think, well, maybe I can make 50, 60, or, you know, sky's the limit. The thing is that you have to actually change that belief. You have to stop believing that you're a specific way. You cannot tie your identity to specific things. Because if you tie your identity to it, you'll find that it'll be extremely hard to shake it. And this will, again, leave you down the same road that you've been, but you can change that by, you know, challenging that belief and start implementing other beliefs that you want to believe in, not what you originally thought, what you are essentially trapped in. So how exactly do we change this, right? How do we get our subconscious to accept good habits, right? How do we get past the gate guards? How do we get past the conscious mind and actually, you know, file it away in the subconscious so that we're doing the good habits? And this is something that you have to actually work towards. It's not something that can, you know, just be developed overnight. So you have to understand that, especially, like I said, if you have a strong belief about something that you want to change, it's going to take time and effort to remove that belief and create new beliefs, create new habits to develop this new self that you want to become. So one thing to keep in mind here is that our brains actually don't know the difference between reality and what is fake. And so if you think about it, our brains, you know, they're encased in a skull, they haven't seen the light of day, and they only deal with the outside world through our different senses. You can recreate a world without limitations. You know, yes, there are some physical limitations in the world, but, you know, mentally, you can essentially be indestructible. You can essentially create a world where nothing is holding you back, where you're not fearful, right? Where you are confident, where you're courageous, where you can go out and be successful in life by just reprogramming your brain. So how do we actually go about doing this? How do we actually go about reprogramming our brain? Now, the best time to do this is either in the morning or as soon as you get up, or in the evening just before you go to bed, or you could even possibly do both. But this is when our brain is more susceptible to be able to accept these images and, you know, recreate a life that we want. Now, the best way to go about this is to actually visualize yourself, right? And I mean in great detail. You want to sit down in a quiet place. You want to, you know, visualize what you want. So if you want a better lifestyle, maybe you want, or possibly even just be more confident, maybe you just want more success in your life, maybe you want, you know, a better relationship in your life, whatever the case may be, you just want to visualize that and then try to get as much detail as possible, right? So if you want to be successful, maybe you want to see yourself speaking in front of hundreds of thousands of people, and you know, visualize yourself giving the speech, how you feel the energy of the crowd, and you just want to get as detailed as possible on whatever it is, and you want to continuously replay that in your mind. And that's what's going to take, is just the repetition, the consistency, and then you will eventually fake your mind to the point that you start believing in it, and it starts actually becoming part of your identity, because your mind doesn't know the difference. And so you're actually going to have to start building the habits that you need for this to be able to sustain this, right? You want to build the habits that will propel you. You don't just want to visualize it and then not, you know, start creating the habits that will help build that up to that, right? Because it all starts with a mindset. And if you can control that mindset and start showing these images, using your senses and programming that subconscious mind, then you'll realize that this just starts becoming natural, right? That you start becoming more confident because you've been visualizing yourself more confident, and you know how you approach the world because you are a more confident person and more successful person because of it. So this is something you want to keep in mind, is to keep the repetitions going, keep the consistency going. Do it in the morning, do it at night, or do it both. But the main thing you need to understand here is that you need to execute this, right? These visualizations do help reprogram your mind, but just thinking about it won't, you know, bring it to reality, right? You're gonna have to execute. You're gonna have to actually create good habits. The visualization actually does tremendously help, and it will correct a lot of things in reprogramming your mind, but you also too have to remember that you're still gonna have to take the steps. You're gonna have to execute on these steps and create the habits. And once all this stuff is in place, you will build your way up. You will realize that you are achieving things that you never even thought possible, that was tied to your old identity. So just remember that, and I hope this helps you guys. If it did, please hit that like button, and until next time, I will see you guys later.